In this tutorial, I'll show you how to draw pixels to a backbuffer and use GDI to copy them to a Win32 window. GDI is Windows' native software rendering library, and we're just going to use it to take our window-sized pixel array and copy it to the window. Note about using GDI that it is much less efficient than using the graphics card via an API like OpenGL, but it's easier to set up and will work on every Windows computer regardless of graphics hardware and driver versions. The code and build script are available in the text version of this tutorial, linked below. To compile, we need to link to GDI 32 in addition to User 32. Much of this code is exactly the same as my opening a window tutorial, so I'll be focusing just on the drawing code. We'll look at the code in two parts: the GDI backend, which takes a pixel array and copies it to the window, and the front end, where we fill our pixel array however we want. In order to copy a pixel array to the window, we need a bitmap info structure to tell GDI about our pixel format, a bitmap handle to encapsulate the info and array data, and a device context handle to point to the bitmap handle. It's redundant, but we have to play by GDI's rules. Before the window is created, we fill out the bitmap info header with information that's never going to change about our pixels. The size of the BMI header has to be set, and the number of color planes is always 1. Our bits per pixel is 32. 8 bits per byte, a byte for each of red, green, and blue, along with a filler byte. The compression type is uncompressed RGB. We create the device context handle, then create the window as usual. When a window is created, it will actually process several messages before letting our program continue. That is to say, it'll both receive and process messages before we ever call peak message and dispatch message. One message which is always processed once the window is created is WM size. This message will also be given to us whenever the window is resized, so it's the one ideal place to assign the size of our pixel array and finish setting up our GDI bitmap. We get the width and height of the window from the lparam passed in with the message. If our bitmap object was already created, we delete it, then create a new bitmap with the unchanged info from before, and the new width and height. Dib RGB colors just tells create dib section what kind of data we're using, and we pass a pointer to our pixel array pointer. Create dib section will fill our pixel array pointer with an address to some memory big enough to hold the type and quantity of pixels we want, based on the width, height, and bits per pixel. Now we've created a bitmap object, we use select object to point our device context to it. Our GDI objects and pixel array memory are set up, so now we need to tell GDI to copy the pixels over to the window. All window drawing has to happen inside the WM paint message. In order to enable window drawing, we'll call begin paint, which fills out this paint struct and gives us a device context handle for painting. The only painting function we need is bitblit, which will copy our pixel array data over to the window in the specified rectangle. We give it the window painting device context, and the left, top, width, and height of the area we want to repaint. Here you could pass in 00 window width, window height, but I follow the conventions and pass in the paint structure rectangle instead. Windows can send you paint messages when things occur, such as part of your window getting covered and uncovered by another window, and will only actually redraw the part of the window that the paint structure dictates anyway, even if you tell it to redraw the entire window here. Next is the device context of our pixel array, and the top left corner to start copying from. Finally, the raster operation code. We just want to copy our pixels over to the window, but there are several other operations available which you could check out for a bit of fun. If we don't call endPaint, everything seems to run fine, but the documentation tells us to, so we do. When dealing with closed source libraries, it's usually best to follow instructions, as you never know if an edge case could mess up your program, or if the library could be updated later. In games, we usually want to redraw the full window many times per second, so at the end of the main program loop, we call these two functions. InvalidateRect marks a section of the window as invalid and needing to be redrawn. Passing in null invalidates the entire window. UpdateWindow immediately passes a WMPaint message to WindowProcessMessage rather than waiting until the next message processing loop, and that allows us to redraw the window whenever we want rather than waiting for Windows to tell us to. That's all the GDI backend stuff, so let's look at the front end now. I created this frame structure to hold just the information our game's drawing routines are interested in: width, height, and the pixel array. The pixel array is allocated by create dib section and the WM size message handling, and we set the width and height at the same time. In the main program loop, you can do whatever you want to fill the pixel array. Pixel 0 ends up being drawn at the bottom left of the window, with the next pixel being drawn one to the right until the row is complete. Then the next row up is drawn. To index to a specific pixel, you could write frame.pixels y times frame width plus x. You need to skip past each row to get to the correct y-coordinate, then go along that row to the correct x-coordinate. Each pixel is 4 bytes representing, from high to low order, filler, red, green, and blue. A nice way to set a pixel's bytes is using hexadecimal, which is a base 16 number system. Decimal is base 10, because there are 10 possible digits, so hexadecimal has 6 extra digits, which are A, B, C, D, E, F. You can think of A through F as representing the decimal numbers 10 through 15 in a single digit. A byte has 256 possible values, and each hex digit has 16. 16 times 16 is 256, so each byte can be represented by 2 hex digits. The bytes of a pixel written in hex, then, look like 0x, the hexadecimal notation, filler filler, red red, green green, blue blue. So for a fully red pixel, you'd write 0x00ff0000. Blue is 0x00000ff. A combination like red and green to make yellow is 0x00ffff00. White is 0x00ffffff. And black is all zeros. So to make the pixel at 3 across, 10 up red, write frame.pixels 10 times frame width plus 3, equals 0x00ff0000. Just make sure you don't access the pixel array outside the bounds, as that will either overwrite some other memory or crash your program. For the sake of demonstration, I've chosen to set each pixel in order to a random value, 1 per frame, while erasing another random pixel to black. With that, we have an automatically resizing pixel array which we can fill however we want, which gets passed over to Windows via GDI and drawn to our window every game loop. In my next tutorials, I'll show you how to handle keyboard and mouse input, play sounds, and load and display images. Cheers!